Hello everyone, welcome to my free online tutorial for the new SAT Math section. This is problem number 22, practice test 4, section 4, calculator allowed. Found in the new SAT official study guide. Okay, so this bar graph was used in the previous problem number 21, and here in this question, problem number 22, we will do a quick calculation. Okay. So, of the following, which best approximates the percent decrease in consumption of wood power in the United States from 2000 to 2010? Right? So it says percent decrease. And percent decrease means that something decreased, right? So let's find wood first of all. Wood is here, right? The last pair of bars here, right? So as you can see, the black one is taller than the gray one. And obviously it makes sense because from 2000 to 2000 is the black one and 2010 is the consumption of wood power, right? So obviously there's a fall in consumption, right? There's a decrease. So we're trying to find percent decrease in consumption, right? From 2000 to 2010. So the way you do that is to simply find the difference of consumption of these two bars, right, these two different years, and then divide it over by the original one, which is the black one, right, the consumption of the shown in the black bar. So let's see, that's going to be 2.25. so how do we know it's 2.25? Well, because it's the midpoint, right? It doesn't say that this figure is not drawn to scale, so obviously it is drawn to scale, so we can use our eyeballing here, and we know that for sure the midpoint between 2 and 2.5 is 2.25, right? If you don't know how to do that, you find the average, which is going to be 2 plus 2.50, that's 4.5 divided by 2. 4.5 divided by 2, if you use your calculator, is 2.25, right? So 2.25 is the difference. Now you divide that by the original one, which is 2.25. Why the original one? Because you're trying to estimate this as the value of reference, right, from which the decrease occurred, right? If it were the increase, you would still use that. So use the first value, use the initial value all the time, not the second value when you divide, but the initial, the first value, right, the value of reference. So this is how it works, 2.25 minus 2, and then divide that by 2.25. And you're not done yet because you're trying to estimate the percentage, right? It will give you a value from 0 to 1, right? Because 100% is 1, 0% is just 0, right? So in value, let's say 50% is 0.5, right? It's a half. So this is why you precisely need to multiply by 100, because this value is going to give you a value between 0 and 1, right? So that's why you need to multiply it by 100 to find percentage. So if you use this in your calculator, plug it in, it will give you 0.1111111. You see, that's between 0 and 1. And you multiply it by 100 and you find the percentage, which is 11.11111, right? And this percentage is the closest one to this answer, 11%, right? Because everything else is way beyond that. So answer choice B is the correct answer choice in this problem.